There is a formula for a scientific paper, and it's important to recognize that a scientific talk is different. There are two different forms of communication. It's not to say that one is better than the other, but they serve different needs.
You cannot just take your paper and translate that into a talk.
A research paper is something that you can sit with for hours on end if needed. You have all the time to pore through the data to make sense of it.
You address all of the controls, all of the caveats, all of the pieces. You probably have both figures in your paper and supplementary data.
The abstract has, it's a summary of the work, but it also has the implications in there, you know, what really came out of the work. So you already have a frame of reference to understand what you're about to read. But what many scientists do when they're giving presentations is, you know, instead of really thinking about what that abstract is doing, they just follow the structure of the paper from kind of the background introduction all the way to the conclusion.
In a talk, you have to have a self-contained story. So you have to provide your audience all the information that they need through your introduction so that they can process the data that you're going to provide in the body of the talk. And in the conclusions, you have to make sense of the data that you've provided them.
It needs to be clear, it needs to be succinct, and it needs to be focused on the things that your audience really needs to know. When you're building a paper, or when it's gone through review, there's often that dreaded reviewer number three that is like the complete stickler. The joke is, oh, reviewer number three. And there's all these things you need to do to satisfy your reviewers and all of these things that maybe end up in your paper or in supplementary data. That sort of stuff is likely never gonna show up in your talk. Your talk is actually responding to like reviewers one and two who like want to know your story and want to hear about it and want to see the data and the important implications.
You really get to include, you know, more of the backstory, more of yourself, really explain why you decided to do the experiments you wanted to do. If you have the time, you're really able to go into like, why did you do this technique? You know, what was important about the setup? Why was this the setup you chose to test this experiment? And how did it help you or not help you in what you were trying to understand about what you were testing?
Talks are an opportunity to present more of a story arc. Were there things that were surprising to you?
Why did you make the decisions that you made?
The things that you tried or that didn't work.
Did you have expectations that weren't met?
What uncertainties did you face?
Talks actually should complement papers. They would provide this high-level view of your project.
It allows scientists to really understand the full picture of the work that you're doing.
There is something that you can convey in person that not only gives a sense of what you've learned and how you've learned it, but why you've done it, the passion that drove you, the story behind not just the discovery, but the person and the circumstances in which that discovery was made.